Hello, everyone. Second live today on my page. Yes, welcome to my weekly live, Sippy Live. Every single week, I do a live and pick a subject to motivate you if you're looking to really moderate or limit or maybe even completely quit sugar and hyperprocessed foods. So today, I said this is my second live on my page today because about half an hour ago, I did the first tip of my own personal challenge, which is 30 days, 30 tips on how to quit sugar. This is my own personal challenge that I'm doing from a course of a wonderful woman named Sarah Cordiner. And basically, I will be doing 30 lives in 30 days, 30 tips how to quit sugar. So if you want to sign, you know, if you would like to see the tips live as they're recorded, then you should absolutely follow, like my page or my YouTube channel. It's going to be there as well. So Zippy GPS to Sugar Free, same name as here. So that's definitely something that you for sure want to check out on. But if you can't, you know, just follow so closely and you would like to get at the end of the 30-day challenge a free copy of all the tips of all the lives in like one nice big package packaged up with a bow for you, you can put your details in the link below, sign up to my newsletter, and then you will get that free package straight to your email when we're done. Besides that, you'll get lots of really cool content like a weekly recording of this live. Now let's talk about the new year. How can we not talk about the new year? It's January 3rd. It's like the beginning of 2022. So maybe we want to reflect. You know, this is really a time, even if you are Jewish and even like, you know, here in Israel, many of us do not really celebrate the new year, like the new calendar year. I did when I was in Canada. I don't today, but it doesn't matter. It's still a big deal. And it still is definitely an opportunity to reflect on what we want for ourselves in the next year, in the next 12 months. And like I say to my clients, it all begins with the food. That's like the first place. So maybe for 2022, you would like to think about where you would like to move from the place you are in today, maybe even if it's only one small step forward regarding your food, your habits, your nutrition, or what you eat. My recommendation to people who are not being professionally counseled, you know, if somebody decides 2022 is the year, they're making a really big change, they feel like they have no control over their food. These are usually like the clients that come to me, right? They have no control over their food. It's like the same way like heavy smokers will smoke, even though they know that they're like killing themselves. These people know that they're harming themselves. They feel bad about it. They're constantly in this like battle of like dieting and then like just gaining weight. You know, I call it the, oh, what the hell syndrome. And this like constant war with food and their problem with connection to food, and people decide 2022 is the year they want to make a real change. I suggest if you really want to make a really big significant change, it's a good idea to do it in some kind of framework, not alone. It's very, very hard. People can do it alone. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I think it's much, much harder, especially if you want that change to be a sustainable change and to be one that will really, you know, be with you long term for the rest of your life. I definitely suggest being in some, whether it's to join a 12-step group or some kind of support group, even if it's a support group on Facebook, there's plenty of really, really good ones. Or if it's working with a, you know, with a counselor, a professional, like some people do when they come to me. So, that's definitely, but even just anyone, even if you maybe have no problem with food, but certainly if you feel that there are certain areas in your life that are problematic, it's not that like dramatic that it needs like this, like, you know, intensive treatment, but you would just like to make that next step to improve your nutrition, to maybe to improve your food habits. So I want to give you some tips on how to do that. Basically, I'm going to give, first of all, it's very, very important to define very clearly what that step is. Saying, I want in 2022 to improve, to eat more, you know, eat healthy. Well, that's great. You know, it's a, but what does that mean? What does eat healthy mean for you? What is that next step to eating healthy for you? Make it something that's actually tangible and practical, right? For example, I'm going to give you an example. Many, many people have a certain food that's their kryptonite, right? Like Superman had that makes him weak, right? There's some people who know that there's a specific food that that is their kryptonite, which means that when they eat it, they have a very hard time controlling it. They'll eat usually more than they intended and maybe more than what is good for them or feels good for them. And then they're sorry about it. And these foods that are kryptonite, maybe that is a food that you would like to give up on this year in 2022, right? Because if there is a food that you're constantly sort of trying to moderate or getting into the ring with, you know, and every single time you lose, then maybe it's time to stop getting into the ring with it. So if there's this one food that you know is your kryptonite, I call these foods, you know, foods maybe that we love but don't love us back. Well, at some point, you know, if you're in a relationship where you love a person who just absolutely does not love you back, isn't there a certain point where you say, you know what, this is not a mutual thing, let's part ways. So maybe with this kryptonite, you want to part ways with a certain specific food for 2022. And then it makes it possible. It makes it something that is actually attainable, because it's not like sort of like, I am giving up and I'm making this really big change and then you do nothing, right? And then you just feel like a freaking failure again and oh, you know, and you give up. Rather than if you take one thing that you actually know from within, like in your heart, in your good place, you know that this is something that is possible for you, that's when you can do it. To take the kryptonite example, my husband Yana is an online running coach. He's run 19 marathons. By the way, he's a great running coach if you're looking for some online coaching. But anyway, he decided at some point, he is, as opposed to me, who I am like a very, very addicted to sugary, starchy, hyper-processed foods. And that's why I really do not eat them. I do not touch them. Okay. Because for me, it's like, that's it. You know, one bite is too many and a million bites are not enough, as they say. But Yana, he's not addicted to sugar. He's not addicted to food. He could moderate and limit, but he decided that he's giving up on sugar and flour because he runs marathons and he had like 2-3 kilos extra on him. And when you ran 42 kilometers, that, you know, it can make it harder. And once he quit, he realized that he feels so much better and he has so much more energy. And also he says he makes it like kind of like a game, like he's beating the system. But the fact that he's not buying into that aggressive marketing and selling that the food companies do of him and all this harmful junk food. So, but he has a kryptonite. His kryptonite is baklava. And he knows that when baklava is like being served somewhere where he is, he just gets up and leaves the table, or he leaves the room, or he goes somewhere else, or he just like physically distances himself from baklava because he knows that's his kryptonite. So, you know, this would be something that you would not take home, that you would not serve it to other people, because then, you know, it's something that weakens your resolve about healthy eating. That would be a good possibility maybe for a 2022 resolution. Or another thing could be, for example, not eating between meals, right? Not stop snack. For 2022, my main focus is going to be on not this like unconscious eating in between meals. I have a meal and then I stop eating. That's a great one. I know somebody who decided on his own to stop eating after 5 p.m. After 5 p.m., he goes into a fast, right? A certain form of like intermittent fasting. Even though he doesn't count the hours, he doesn't do 8:16 or anything like that. He just decided that 5 o'clock is a good cutoff time for him for his eating, and he doesn't eat after 5 p.m. He didn't change anything else. He eats everything that he always ate in the same amount, in the same way, but at 5 p.m., he says he goes into fast. And he lost 10 kilos that way, right? So he just did one thing. This guy, he just he, you know, he, we'll call him Mark. So Mark did just this one thing that he knew that for him is possible, is attainable. Now, once he's lost 10 kilos, just from that one change of not eating after 5 p.m., now maybe he's ready to make another change. Like, I don't know, like eating more whole foods and less junk and all kinds of stuff like that. So what I would really say is, if you're going to make a 2022 resolution, a New Year's resolution regarding food, don't make it something general. Make it something very, very specific, and make sure that it is something that is absolutely attainable to you. Better to go, a little lower, and then if you do more, you're like, just rather than like setting this very, very high bar and then you don't get to it. But you did do something, but because you didn't get to the bar that you set, then well, I failed, and then it's not worth anything, and then you stop everything. So that doesn't really work, does it? And that's our usually our natural tendency. So don't do the thing that you wish you could. Do the thing that you actually know is a possible, attainable, specific goal for you for 2022. And if your goal for 2022 is really to make a huge, really significant change with a professional, with professional guidance, then please reach out to me, because really, I maybe we can work together and make a really big shift for 2022. That's it for this week. See you next week, Tuesday at 2:30. There will be a second link in this video if you want to sign up to get my weekly live every single week. It's the same sign up to my newsletter. You just anybody who signs up to my newsletter gets all the great stuff that I have to give out to the world. I'll see you next week, Tuesday, 2:30 at sorry, at 4:30, Sippy Live. Follow my 30 days, 30 tips challenge. You'll get some really fantastic tips on quitting sugar. And have a great day, wonderful evening, and an amazing 2022. Bye bye.